struggling on finding the right papers to read, to learn, or cite papers in your research field, I want to give you an easy tutorial today in Research Rabbit, a really awesome tool to be able to find great papers to be able to read for you. If you don't have Research Rabbit yet, go to researchrabbit.ai. The link will also be in the description below. And then you can sign up using an institutional email address and use my referral code to jump ahead in the wait list, which is going to be on the screen here and is going to be in the description below. So here is my research rabbit, and I'm going to show you how to go through all of these things. So the first thing I'm going to do is show you how to create a new collection. So a new collection could be for a theme in your field or your field in general. It's really up to how you want to organize things. So you can start a new collection, and in this one, I'm going to do steroids and eye mobility. I already have my own steroids and eye mobility collection, but for this case, because I'm doing it for this video, I want to have it as a separate collection. So the first thing you're going to do is it's going to create this collection here, and you have to add papers first to be able to get started. So I'm going to click Add Papers. And so this is where you can search for papers, either based off the title, if you know the title, or keywords. So, or if you have the BibTeX or RIS for your paper already that you're interested in, you can add it in here. In this case, I'm just gonna search my go-to keywords, which is steroids and eye mobility, and it's going to look for papers. Here you can actually choose biomedical and life sciences, where it'll mainly search PubMed, or you can choose all subject areas where it's searching Semantic Scholar. So this is a good review. Let's add that to my collection. So that's now added in. And then, yeah, let's add this one. This is my own paper here. Ooh, and then this one may also be good because it's eye mobility for steroid metabolites. So that's interesting. So I'm just adding a few papers so that Research Rabbit can understand what I'm looking for within this collection. So now if I exit out of that, you can see my papers are now populated here. And I've now unlocked these different things down here. So I can search for earlier work or later work. This will happen once you have at least two papers in here. It'll start populating the earlier and later work. I can also search for similar work. So this is mainly based on the keywords. The earlier and later work is going to be mainly based on who's citing who. And then I can look at these authors or suggested authors. So I want to go through each of these for you. So we can look at earlier work. So here you can see this network view. And so I want to kind of show you a couple of different things about here. Whenever you go over a paper, it's going to bring up the authors on that paper, the year, the journal, and the title of that paper, as you can see here. The papers that are not in your collection are going to show up blue, where the papers that are in your collection are going to show up green. The other thing is when you go over a paper, you're going to start seeing arrows coming out from it. So the arrow head will always go to the paper that's been cited, if that makes sense. So those arrows can either be blue or green. If it's green, it's because it's related to the paper that's within your collection. And if it's blue, it's related to a paper not in your collection. So you can start seeing kind of different themes emerging here. So a lot of these are going to be eye mobility analysis of steroids. If we come down here, we're getting a lot more of just biomarkers of steroids instead of it being specifically eye mobility analysis down here, or just general information about steroids. So you can see that's kind of this nestled here. Down here, you're going to get information just about eye mobility in general. And so these aren't going to be as related to steroids. And then over here, we're getting more the eye mobility plus steroids. So this is how the network analysis will work, where you can actually see, you know, the different networks that are appearing here. You can always click on any of these. So let's click on this one, and it's going to bring out the abstract for this. And then you can add it to this collection or add to another collection. I do want to let you know that if you're going to add to another collection, you do need to create that collection first and then add it to it. So in this case, I could basically create three collections here. I could have one for steroids where I can add this bulk of papers into. I could have one for eye mobility where I could add this bulk of paper. And then I can add these to this collection right now, which is steroids and eye mobility. So I'm going to add this one to this collection. So that is basically how you can kind of navigate this. The other things I want to show you real quick is you can also toggle this to last name. So you're going to see really the PIs or the corresponding authors that are on this compared to the first name. And then the other thing you can do is look at this in a timeline view. So it'll do this initially and then it will move in a second. These are all the papers that aren't in your collection, where these are the ones that are in your collection, and you can see them through a timeline. So now I want to go back to my collection. So I'm going to exit out of all of those and come back here. So I just did the earlier work. You can also look at later work. So these are all the works that have come out after the papers in here. So you can see a lot of these are 2020, 2021. The other option is you have similar work. So this is going to be probably your biggest bucket of papers because it's mainly matching keywords instead of matching citation networking. So you can see you have a whole lot more papers here that you can have access to and look through. And again, this is going to kind of separate out by network analysis as well. So you can see all of these down here are mainly related to just IMAbility. So you can see these are mainly related to LC IMS. Over here, we have more just steroid information up here. So you can see how these are kind of separating out. And then the ones over here are steroid analysis by IMAbility. So you can find similar themes with looking through this, and then you can always add these to their own collections as well. So that's a general look about how all of this works. You can always exit out up here, and it will come back to this. You can also leave comments on any paper by just clicking here and entering your comment if you want to add some notes about these papers. So now I want to talk about how you can use this to cite papers. So one thing you can do is you can export the BIB or the RIS by clicking these buttons up here, but you can also sync to Zotero. And so I've been kind of walking you through how to use Zotero. So I want to show you how to sync to Zotero. So in this case, if you just click this here, I have four papers in here. So let's say I want all of these citations into a collection on Zotero. So I'm going to sync to Zotero and I'm going to write RR steroids and ion mobility and click OK. So then I can jump into my Zotero. If you haven't created a Zotero account or synced to Zotero yet, you're going to have to first connect to Zotero. It just requires a free Zotero account and it will connect up together. So then you can come in here. So this is my Zotero and you can see it's filling in those papers because it's syncing. So if it doesn't automatically sync, you can come over to the right and click this green arrow and that will sync it. If you're not logged in on your Zotero yet, go to Edit and Preferences and then hit Sync and there will be a login here. And so you can just log in and it will give you access to sync everything to your Zotero. So now I have all these references in here. You can see in each of these references, it pulled in the information and the abstract, but it's not going to pull in like the full text or anything like that. So if you want to see how I would further organize this within Zotero, you can check out this video above about how I organize all of my citations within Zotero. And you can always move things from your Research Rabbit into other collections or subfolders if you have those in here. So that is overall how to use Research Rabbit. If you, again, don't have access, use my referral code below and go ahead and get access. It's a great tool for you to be able to use. And if you are struggling with what papers to read or you're just trying to learn your field, check out my 30-day research jumpstart guide. It's going to walk you through which papers you need to find and read to be able to learn your field and start collecting publishable data within 30 days. I hope you enjoyed this video and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.